Good morning, everybody. I'm Ernest, and I'm at the ranch again. So it seems like doing my YouTube videos, people are liking more the firearms and the motorcycle type videos. That's the ones I get the most views on. So today, we're going to talk about the Heritage Rough Rider. And there's just a little 22 plinker. Feels good in the hand, it's heavy. One of the unique features of the firearm is it has a safety right here, which I probably need because I just pointed it at my face. But it's also good for kids, and because it has that feature, there's only a six shooter that I know of that has that particular feature. You can also carry it in your holster. With all six shots in there, knowing because you got a safety there. I bought this at Academy about 200 rounds ago. I can't remember how many. It's maybe 2 years I've had this particular firearm. It's got fixed old style sights. You know, it's not adjustable. You can file this down if you want to. And I got it for $99 on it was right at during the holidays, right before the world got crazy, you know, with COVID and everything. Prices were reasonable. I got it for $99, which is pretty cheap. I think they're like regular, like 140 from what I remember. I haven't priced them lately. I don't know what they are now, but it's got some wooden stocks with some stars on there, blue in finish. It is a value type firearm. Nothing fancy about it other than this little safety here being kind of unique, I think. So let's put it through its paces and let's just see how good is it or not. And we'll talk about it some more. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do here is like a reliability test. And I have it in safety. And I'm gonna see if it will not fire. Okay, so the safety works good. The next thing we're gonna do is shoot all six shots and see how reliable it is. I think that's it. Six shots, pretty good. On to the next accuracy test. Okay, we had a little hang up here, so it shot well, but what has happened is when I go to unload it, I got the first one out with the rod, you know, but it's some of the bullets or the cartridges after firing it, I guess, expand it and push back a little bit, and that's making it difficult or impossible to rotate. Okay, that one came out, and so I might have to remove the cylinder completely. No, I'm getting it. So some of them come out easy, some of them don't. So I'm sure that's due to the fit and finish. It's not exactly milled perfectly, but so I've had that problem. It's hard to unload. I don't know if the next shots are going to be the same, but I just wanted y'all to be aware of that I did encounter that problem. All right, so let's load it up again and see how we do on the accuracy test. Or maybe it's my accuracy test, not so much the Rossi. I mean the Heritage. Okay, so I just finished shooting, let's see, 6, 12, 18 rounds. This is the first set, second set, and the final set. I improved a little bit with each time, and I think the issue is the sights. Those sights are fixed, and you can't adjust them. There's a spider on me. And so you have to kind of adjust your aim each time. I think it's pretty good. I was about 6 yards away. Not impressive, but I think with time, learning the sights, I don't shoot this firearm. I mean, it's been over a year since I shot this thing. And I'm not really into handguns. I'm more into rifles and shotguns. Well, rifles mostly. And but the main thing that I'm having with this gun is the unloading. It's still giving me, each time I finish shooting six, there's one shell or so that is pushed out, and it's making it hard to turn the cylinder to eject the rounds. But other than that, it hasn't misfired. I think the accuracy can be improved with the most use out of it, and it does have a safety on it, one of the main selling points on it. And I got it for $99. I don't know if you can get it that much for that much anymore, but anyway, that's my review on the Heritage Rough Rider. Now there is Ruger's. They make a firearm that costs quite a bit more than this one, but it probably is better. I've seen reviews on that one, and people really like that one. And maybe if I cleaned my gun, maybe that unloading issue wouldn't happen anymore, but that's not the case right now. So anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you later.